Hi, and welcome to today's announcements. A representative from Northwood University will be here September 13th during sixth hour. If you wish to meet with the representative, sign up in the counseling office. Attention NHS members, our first meeting is Tuesday, September 11th. During first hour, elections for officers will be held. Need NHS hours? Workers are needed for the first MSU football game against Central Michigan on September 8th. Sign up in the counseling office beginning Tuesday. And now here's some information on school policies.
Remember when you ran away and I got on my knees and begged you not to leave because I go berserk? Well, you left me anyhow, and then the days got worse and worse, and now you see I've gone completely out of my mind. And they're coming to take me away, ha-ha, they're coming to take me away, ho-ho, hee-hee, ha-ha, to the funny farm where life is beautiful all the time, and I...
Sorry, didn't mean to be tardy already. Anyways, it's been a busy week in sports, so let's get right to the action. The girls' basketball team defeated Charlotte last night, 61-49. Leading the Vikings in scoring were Maria Schirini with 14 and Renee Nooner with 11. The Viking football team defeated Jackson Northwest last week. Squeak ran for 124 yards and one touchdown. Chris Hunt scored twice, and the Hazel defense had three interceptions and allowed only 66 points. The soccer team is on a roll after going 4-0 last night, topping Portland 5-0. Sean McCarthy had a hat trick. They also won the Hazlitt Invitational last weekend. Leading the team in scoring were Sean Brogan with 3 goals, and Josh Weaver scored his first and second goals ever. Congratulations, Josh. The girls' swimming team took third in the Oscoda Invitational last weekend. Placing first were Julie Ford and Corey Keck. Congratulations, girls. Now let's go to Tom Short to meet this week's team of the week.
Losing the home opener. What sorts of things are you guys going to work on to be that number one team that I know you guys are?
Well, I think a few things we're going to work on. We're going to work on our offense a little bit better execution, but I thought we did a great job. I thought that we need to work a little bit when we move our press to the three-quarters court. We needed to learn how to rotate a little bit better in that. But I'll tell you what, we played hard. I thought Trotter, Dana Carr, my whole team, my whole bench. I thought Rappel J did a nice job of coming in and playing the one for us. I thought Kelly did a nice job. You know, I just can't say enough about the kids. They battled to get it into overtime. Trotter hit that big three. And, you know, hey, they shot a little bit better at the free throw line to get them to that point in overtime. And then, you know, we stepped it up, and I thought we played real well tonight.
So you guys have a tough, long road trip coming up. Where's your next game at?
We're playing at Charlotte, and then after that, we have our next four games on the road. Two league games will be within that, Portland and Fowlerville, and then Eden Rapids and Waverly. So we're going to be the road crew because we got six tough ones coming.
Was the Terrace Troops loud enough for you in the student section?
Well, you know what, we got to say, you guys helped us. It was awesome in here tonight. The crowd was great. Terrace Troops, you know, we can't do it without you guys. We want you the whole season. At one point, I couldn't even hear myself talk. You guys were so loud. I mean, it was great, fantastic.
The The homecoming dance is October 6th. It will begin at 8:30. For those of you who are going to the hockey game at Spartan Stadium that night, you will be let in until 9:30. If you have your tickets up from the game, you will be let in until 10. Callbacks for the Pirates of Penzance will be posted today after school. Pick up all callback information in the choir room. And now here's David Fidowa with the weather.
Hi, this is Viking Country and my name is David Fidowa, your meteorologist for today. Here's your weather for August 30th, Thursday. We have on the west coast, we have some cumulus clouds accumulating, bringing in the cold and the warm. And here for the Midwest, there's a low pressure zone bringing over here into Hazlet, the low pressure zone with the rain, and the cumulus clouds are coming across, bringing the rain for tonight's game. So bring your umbrellas and be ready for a good game. So back to you in the studio.
Thank you, Squeak. That was amazing. Anyways, a freshman homecoming float meeting will be held today in the Viking Room at 2:20. All freshmen interested in helping design and build their float should go to the Viking Room immediately after 6th hour today. Any fall athlete who has not yet had their picture taken and would still like to needs to see Mrs. Shively immediately. All appointments need to be set by Thursday, September the 6th. The pictures will be taken the next day starting at 2:30. Now back to you, Suze.
What do school improvement, your future, and the letters CC, TW, and FISH have in common? You are about to see a 17-minute film that will answer this question. Our school is working towards something called the North Central Accreditation, and having a plan to improve our schools is part of the process. All of the teachers are in committees to work in four areas of improvement, which are character, critical thinking, technology, and writing. Get it? CC, TW. And as you are about to see, CCTW also stands for four things we can all do to make our school a better place and a more fun place to be. We also thought you'd like to see this because, face it, we're all thinking about our future careers and how we can be happy as we begin working. Believe it or not, a bunch of guys in a fish market seem to have the answer. Oh, and by the way, the letters CCTW also stand for Can Change the World. So watch this.